Hello, friends. I'm excited to announce season 4 of 10 Questions with Rick Henry Christopher. I am returning after a 6-month break. And kicking off this season, my first guest is the talented singer Tori Holub. She is known for her vocal resemblance to Karen Carpenter of the iconic 1970s duo The Carpenters. Tori, it is such an honor to have you here today.
Hi, Rick. Thanks for having me on.
On the day that you were born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true. So they sprinkled moon dust in your hair, a golden starlight in your eyes of blue.
When did you first realize you could sing like Karen Carpenter?
I personally don't think that I sound just like Karen. I think she was an amazing one person, an individual that can never be replicated, and I have so much respect for her, as well as Richard, and the work that they did together. I just don't think could ever be replicated or, you know, matched in any way. But I'm of course super, super flattered any time that I see a comment saying that I remind them of Karen, because obviously she's like my vocal inspiration.
Did you have to practice to get that sound?
I wouldn't say I had to practice to get that sound. I think it was oddly something that came very naturally to me in terms of the inflections. And Karen and I have, at least her documented range, I believe it's like a D below middle C is like the lowest note she can go. You know, that all is pretty much the same. I'm sure she could go much lower and much higher than I can.
How do you prepare before singing a Carpenter song?
Nowadays, I usually just jump right into it. I have my Pro Tools, I have my mic, and I just kind of go into it. I haven't done a lot of the short form videos lately, but when I do, that's kind of just what I do. I just kind of jump into it, and I might, you know, do it a couple times just to kind of warm up a little bit. But I don't really have like a set routine or vocal warm ups that I do, which I know is terrible, but I just kind of go for it.
You recently sang at the Carpenters' 55th anniversary celebration. Can you share more about your experience?
Oh, the Carpenters' 55th. That was such a cool experience. It was like, I want to say 4 days of just nonstop like activities, and we went on bus tours. It was like being in elementary school and going on a field trip again. It was so much fun. But the concert, that was something really special to be a part of. And I'm really honored that they asked me to do it. The 55th committee was so gracious. City of Downey, and of course Downey Methodist Church, was just an amazing place to be able to perform at. This is really only, it was only my second time performing as an adult in front of a lot of people, so it was a big thing to overcome. But the fact that my second performance was at a place with that much history and significance to the things that I'm interested in is just so honorable. And the committee really made that happen for me, so I'm really, really honored. And it was really awesome to meet the other performers who are kind of, you know, in a way, like, we're all in the same boat, you know, just trying to, you know, make a living off of music and specifically off of the Carpenters, you know? So it was really, really fun to meet everybody. And there were some people who came I mean, of course, a part of the event, but there were some people that came, you know, just to see me or just to see, you know, some of the other performers. And that was all very flattering. And yeah, it was just an incredible experience, and I'm so grateful for it.
Ever do. And as I watch you framed in sunlight and a sky of blue, I know what my life's been leading to. Something in your eyes sees all I ever wanted, and something in your smile for me is calling out my name. Your eyes, it seems, are the earth of my dreams in ways I can't explain, and my heart will never be the same.
Of all the Carpenters' songs you've recorded, which one was the most challenging?
I would say my Bacharach David medley was pretty tough because I do all the harmonies by ear. So it was like four-part harmony and beyond. And, you know, so I was just listening to the song over and over again and listening to a cappella and listening, you know, to get all of those harmonies together. And I also had to edit out Karen and Richard's harmonies as best as I could from that backing track that I had because it was an instrumental that had all the harmonies still attached. So it was quite the task, but that's one of my favorite songs by them, so I was really happy to do it.
Go while the going is good, knowing when to leave may be the smartest thing that anyone can learn. Go, I'm afraid my heart isn't very smart. Fly while you still have your wings, knowing when to leave or never let you reach the point of no return. Fly. Foolish as it seems, I still have my dreams. So I keep hoping day after day as I wait for the man I need, night after night as I wish for a love that can be. Though I'm sure that no one can tell where the wishes and hopes will be, somehow I feel there is happiness waiting for me. When someone walks in your life, you just better be sure it's right, cause if it's wrong, there are heartaches and tears you must pay. Keep both of your eyes on the door, never let it get out of sight. Just be prepared when the time has come, you run away.
You've done an impressive recording of We've Only Just Begun with James Wilkus. Tell us about this project.
Thank you. I'm so glad you liked it. That was a lot of fun to work on with James Wilkus. Pretty much the story goes that James reached out to me. He already had this track of We've Only Just Begun ready to go. And he saw my videos and he just wanted to, you know, repurpose it for me to sing on it, which is so flattering, and he's been such a joy to work with, and we actually are working on Close to You now.
A kiss for luck and we're on our way. Before the rising sun. Start up walking and learn to run.
Do you ever feel Karen's presence while singing her songs?
I'm not consciously thinking of her presence around me while I sing, but you know, I think it's a weird thing to say, but from like a spiritual standpoint, I really do feel like she is everywhere all at once, if that makes sense. And I've briefly talked about this with some of the other performers at the 55th, which they just had brought up anyways. But I think a lot of us have, you know, we kind of carry Karen with us, if that makes sense. And I think that I feel like we all kind of have these interesting stories or coincidences that just it just makes it so much more apparent that she's with us on this earth. And I don't know if it's her or just some sort of residual, you know, energy or something, whatever you believe. But I think it's very cool how my connection to the Carpenters has basically orchestrated, you know, an entire career. And I don't think it's, you know, a coincidence.
How do you feel about comments comparing your voice to Karen Carpenter's, noting that there is only one Karen Carpenter and nobody can ever come close to doing what she has done?
Well, like I previously mentioned, you know, I kind of am of the same opinion that there is nobody that sounds like Karen Carpenter. So I think when I see those comments, it's really stating the obvious, and I really don't think there's any real purpose for it. You know, because it's, I think some people think that I need to hear reality, or, you know, they think that I'm so, you know, head in the clouds that, you know, I think that I am Karen Carpenter, when really, you know, if that's something that's been said, it's something put on me by other people. I think that I'm, you know, an individual that will have my own path, and Karen was just one of a kind, and again, have so much respect for her and her career and her voice and all of her hard work. Yeah.
I love your song, Something to Believe In. It's absolutely beautiful. Please give us some background on the song and how it came to be.
I'm so glad you like the new single. That was presented to me by Richard Craft and Jimena Caballero. And also the music was done by Jeffrey Hoppener. And they are just wonderful people. And they already had this song and they rearranged it in a very Bacharach Carpenters-esque way. And just the lyrics, the composition, everything just really struck a chord with me. So I was so happy to do it. And again, they're all wonderful people. And I was honored that they involved me in this wonderful song.
Maybe I am just a fool, seeking kindness in the cruel. Though dreams may be deceiving, they give me something to believe in.
So what's next on your agenda? Do you have any new projects you're working on?
There's not too much I can talk about at the moment, but I do have a video coming out for Something to Believe In, which is really exciting. Right after I did the whole, you know, week events of the Carpenters 55th, we went down to Studio City and we shot a music video. which was really, really exciting, and I'm really honored. And the whole crew was so patient. It was really amazing. It was like a real set. And I really think that people are gonna love the video concept. And yeah, I'm really excited. I also have a song coming out sometime soon, called Years Gone By. I've been working on it for probably the past 3 or 4 months, which is insane. But I'm such a perfectionist. I brought the demo and the concept of the song to my good friends Steve Eaton and Donnie Demers, who I knew would just do an excellent job taking it into their own hand and just working their magic. So with them, I refined the lyrics and I did all the music and production work, and I'm really excited for everyone to hear it. So,
Tori, I thank you very much for your time. And I truly enjoy listening to you sing. You have a beautiful voice, and I love how you associate with your fans. You become friends with a lot of them, and that really says a lot about you and the kind of person you are. I wish you the best in your career, and I hope to hear much, much more from you. Thank you very much for doing this interview with me. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Rick. Those words mean so much to hear. More than you know. And thank you so much for having me on. It was an absolute pleasure.